Oh, you know you don't. There's no time for a weak link. The strong survive in the weak sink. Put your trust in me, I clear the pathway. Cause I don't do things halfway. Let's start the show. We're in charge. We're just letting you know. It's all or nothing.
Welcome to Varsity Four. Tonight, teams played a high school football under the Monday night lights. Many games from this past Friday were postponed to tonight because of Hurricane Milton. So this week, we have two Varsity Four shows, twice the amount of fun. And just like Jamal St. Cyr said, if you're playing, we'll be there. If you would like to see scores from all of our area games, scan the QR code at the bottom of your screen and it will direct you to our website, newsforjax.com. Let's get to the game of the week. It's a Nassau County rivalry, Fernandina Beach against Yulee. The game was supposed to be played at Yulee High School, but it was moved to Fernandina Beach. Now, the Hornets have controlled this series. They've won 10 straight in 14 of 17 all-time meetings. But Fernandina Beach has the better record entering this matchup at 4-3. So is this the year they reclaim the rivalry title? Yulee's Preston Matricardi hands it off to Ethan Myers, who runs to the sideline and cuts downfield. Watch him break away from the defender who gets his hands on him. Myers with the Hornets first to touchdown. Now Beckham Rowe drops back, looks deep, tries to pass to Aiden Poe, but it falls perfectly into the hands of Jadian Wright, who intercepts Fernandina Beach. Now second quarter, Matricardi hands it off to Shamar Gibbs, who finds a lane, runs into the end zone for the second touchdown of the game. Yulee up 13-0 now. It works so nicely, so why not try it again? Run it back. Matricardi hit off to Gibbs. Touchdown, 20-0 lead as this game started to run away with the score at third quarter. The Pirates finally have answers, though. Rowe decides to keep it himself, run into the end zone for Fernandina Beach's first and only score of the night. But their celebration is short-lived. On the kickoff, right after the touchdown, watch this play. Ethan Myers picks it up at the one-yard line. Wait, what's going to happen right here? He gets by quite a few Yulee players. Then he gets in front of everyone with only green grass in front of him. Will he do it? Yes, he will. Myers' 99-yard kick return. Well, Matricardi wants to be a part of the scoring as well. All his teammates have gotten in the end zone, so why not him? Yulee just tore apart Fernandina Beach. Matricardi showing poise. He launches the ball downfield to DJ Mason, who walks into the end zone for the last and final touchdown of the game. This is a big one. Final score 42-7. The Hornets extend their win streak against their rival to 11 straight games now.
I thought we executed football really well. I have a lot of kids that have bounced in and out and playing different positions. Got a lot of young kids playing up. I mean, our linebacker crew, Jason Brown, Parker Wilson, Tegan Rabane, two of those kids been playing JV for us. One of them's a freshman. They played phenomenal tonight, I thought, being able to shut down a lot of the things that Fernandina was doing. Fernandina's got a really good running back, and we were just able to execute football. Offensively, I thought we were played pretty clean. A couple holding penalties, but we still made big plays, even though we had those opportunities. Only punted twice and no turnovers. So I was really pleased with our performance. They did a phenomenal job, all five of those guys. Sage Newberry is our kind of fullback tight end kid. He did a phenomenal job tonight. Blake Lear stepped in at tight end, and they kind of led the way. But Shamar and Ethan make big play after big play after big play, and Corbin does a great job stepping in and being able to spell those guys when they're tired from doing a lot of the other things on special teams. I do got three really good running backs, and I got a fourth that should be out there with us who is an unbelievable athlete.
Obviously a weird week last week with Hurricane Milton coming through, and this game was supposed to be at your place last Friday. Obviously things changed. What do you make of your crew's ability to adapt, come in here, and have a great win?
Yeah, I mean, we talk about facing adversity all the time. We're facing it. Like, we got 13 kids that should be playing for us that are out for injuries right now. So there's a lot of kids that aren't even playing for us that could or should be. And we don't make excuses for it. We just come out and say the next person, the next play. We just look and find the next way to just find success and keep striving for, you know, that greatness that we're trying to push these kids for. That's all that they're searching for right now.